Hello, I'm going to talk about explainable AI and how we can implement it and how it helps to reduce the landslide risk and hazards. The problem that we're trying to solve is to basically make science more accessible to the decision makers, where we want to show what we have done in a scientific community to be used in the real world applications by making different softwares or the user applications where they can see the results as more interpretable way for the decision makers.
Okay, what is the alternative? If you don't do it with explainable AI, what is the alternative?
So the alternative to that would be just publishing our results, and then the problem is not being used because it will be way more complex. The results from an artificial intelligence model will be way more complex for the users or for the decision makers in the local government to understand what does it really mean, and the decision based on those results might be very different than what it would be if it is explained in a proper way to the local governments.
Okay. Can you show us your application then?
Oh yes, of course. So the application that we built using explainable AI, it's a simple web-based platform where users from different local governments or the decision makers can go and see that at a different color levels, starting from green to red, green meaning less prone to landslides and red meaning very high landslide hazard in a color pattern. And then if you look at different locations here, you can see at the same location or in the same mountain, we have all three kind of classification. One is green, another is red, and another is yellows. So that means even if there is same kind of earthquake or ground shaking at the same location, there will be different response from the ground, or there will be high or less hazard. So when they are building road or they are building more new infrastructure, they need to know why there is less hazard in green and in high in the red. So to show that, actually, they can just go to the system and click, and then in the left, it will show why the model thinks that it has a very high hazard or it has a less hazard. So in the right, in the left panel, we can see the different parameters that we used in the modeling, how do they influence the model, and how they sum up to a certain value to show the probability of having landslides.
Okay, so if I understand correctly, the a normal AI or non-explainable AI would end up in a colorful map without the graphs. And what you're adding at is the maps. And where is this running?
This is running at the Istri server from the UT. That's sponsored by UT. So we have all the data loaded in the system. And then whenever we click on here, it queries the result from one server and then show it to us in the screen. And yes, coming back to your previous question, yes, if we don't have explainability, then we'll not know why this slope is more hazardous or has more probability of having a landslide.
Oh, very nice. So who are the users of this kind of tool?
So this is scientific research, of course. It has not been used in real-world application yet, but if it is used by, it will be mostly the local governments. Before the disaster happens, it will be the governments or the planning agencies. And during a disaster, it would be mostly, let's say, the Red Cross or the response teams or the army who has to go and do the rescue during a disaster. So those people who help during the disaster would be using
And why do we need to use AI and not any other
So that's a good question. First of all, the AI is quite, it works in non-linear ways. In science, they call it non-linear, but to put it simply, it would be like it can understand the hidden relations between different variables, let's say slope and how steep is the slope, what is the precipitation in past few months. So the In a linear way, it will be very difficult to find the hidden relations. So AI can extract more meaningful information based on the given data. And second, also the performance of the AI is quite good compared to the statistical or let's say human-made decisions. And also on top of that, if we have to do it, classify manually, the AI is actually the replication of human brain, what we do as a scientist. But if we have to do it manually for the whole country or for whole Earth, that will not be feasible. So I think that we are just trying to replicate what we already know to a model.
Can I ask you why you chose this path? Why did you want to do this?
Yes, because I come from Nepal, and we have a lot of disasters almost every year. We had 2015 earthquake. When I was in the university, I saw a lot of disasters. And also when I was young, when I was a child, I had to cancel my schools every now and then because of the landslide risk. Then there is a lot of rainfall, and then we know, okay, there will be a landslide, so don't want to obviously die, so we don't go to schools. So I was trying to solve in a way to reduce those risks or to reduce the amount of money or house, whatever people have, like how do they lose. So to reduce those loss, I try to come to science to solve those problems.
Okay, it's very nice. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Do you want to be a GeoHero as well? Then take the first step and click the subscribe button and then the bell button to always be the first to know when one of our GeoHeroes posts a new video.